So slight variations in the asanas and holding them for a longer duration can help you to build up the strength in major muscle groups as well as the small stabilizing muscles while building the coordination at the same time. So let's hit the mat with some of these challenging poses in the mind. So when you're looking at building strength with the help of your yoga practice, you can incorporate a lot of variations of the plank position. So in order to get into the plank position, you just simply spread your fingers wide open on the mat and let yourself extend your legs out in front. Let yourself extend your legs out at the back. Now once you hold that position, you simply stay there focusing on your breath. Focusing more on the exhalation would allow you to engage your core muscles better. Visualize that your navel is going towards the spine as you breathe out slowly. So from there, you bring both your feet together and lift your chin up. And now let yourself lift your left leg up. Holding that position would engage your core muscles, muscles along the thighs, glutes, upper back, muscles around your spine and your triceps. Continue holding that position and hold that position for almost about 8 to 9 breaths. When you're done, slowly put your left leg down and do the same thing with your right leg up in the air. As you breathe out, you're going to let yourself lower the right foot down and now slowly bring your left leg up in the air and bring the knee up close to the left shoulder. Hold this position for about 6 breaths and then place the foot down back onto the mat and the same thing on the other side. Breathe out, put your foot down back onto the mat, lower the knees down and relax. So this is slightly more challenging than the other ones. So you just have to set your feet wide as your mat is, and let yourself have a broader base to balance on. Lift your chin up, look right in front. And at this point of time, we'll be lifting the left arm up and the right leg up. Breathe out and back. Same thing on the other side. Breathe out and back, slowly come out of the plank and relax. And you can hold this position for like 6 to 8 breaths. So once you're back into the base position plank, you can simply let yourself bring your feet together as close as they can and let yourself shift your body weight forward with the help of your toes. When you breathe out, you just have to simply bend your arms and go down slowly, as slow as you can. Your body stays just slightly above off the mat. Hold that position and be able to breathe. You can hold that position for like 6 to 8 breaths. And when you're done, you can slowly put yourself down onto the mat and relax. And the next position when you're looking at the strength would be boat position. So making the boat position as the base position and adding on to the variations to the boat position can also help you to strengthen up core muscles of your body. So what you have to do is you just simply pull yourself back a little bit so that you have your body weight more towards your hips, and then you can gently lift your feet up off the floor. At this point of time, you already notice that your core muscles are getting engaged. Extending the right, both your legs out in front, you'll be extending both your arms out in front. Hold that position to begin with for 4 to 5 breaths, and then slowly when you're ready, you can bring your hands together and send your legs out wider. Now this shifts the body weight away from the center of the gravity, so which means your muscles will be working further. Then you bring your legs together, and then you open your arms out wide, and then switch. You can switch the legs and the position of the arms from 10 to 12 times. So many variations of the Virasana can also help you to get the strength you're looking at. So you'll be simply sending your legs out wide. So to begin with, point your right foot vertically away from the left. And then place your left foot behind in a way that your right foot is perpendicular to the left at the back. So reach out with your toes and then simply bring both your arms at your shoulder level. But at this point of time, you simply start bending your right leg and sink down with your hips. And you sink down to the point where you get your right thigh parallel to the floor. And make sure that your knee stays either above the heel or stays slightly behind it. Avoid taking the knee beyond the ankle. At this point of time, you hold that and sink down while you focus on your breath. And once you're done, you'll be simply placing your right elbow on top of the right knee and let yourself hang your hand loose and supple. Now move the left arm over the head and reach out with your fingers as far as it can get. Continue sinking down. Keep breathing in and out. And from there, when you breathe out, you're going to bring your left arm back all the way and wrap the arm around the body in a way that you are able to grab your right thigh. Once you have that grip, you pull your chest back and extend your right arm out in front. Continue breathing, sinking down. You still notice that the strength of the right thigh helps you to hold that position. Breathe. When you breathe out, you're going to let yourself extend the right arm up. Sink a little further down. You can look up toward the skies. As you breathe out, you're going to let yourself lower the right hand down on the inside of the right foot. Now, the moment your right hand comes down, then the weight comes on your right hand. Now, at this point of time, you're going to let yourself bring your right hand between your legs and wrap the arm around the legs in a way that you manage to grip your wrist at the back. Now, this is where it gets challenging because the entire weight is on your right thigh at this point of time. Focus on this position. Hold that, endure the position, and hold this position for like 4 to 6 breaths. Once you're done, you're going to slowly bring your right hand down back onto the same position. Send your left arm up higher, and from there, when you breathe out, you're going to bring your left hand down onto the place where your right hand is. And that's when you send your right arm up higher, adding a twist into the spine. Now, breathe out, bring your right elbow on top of the right knee, and send your left arm up higher. Remember that your hand would remain relaxed. Keep your left hand exactly where it is. Simply start pushing your elbow into the knee in a way that you get your right leg straight. Extend your right arm down and then join your hands together. Now pressing with your toes in front, bring the body up using the strength of the obliques. Bring the arms down, back to the center, and then you repeat the same sequence and the series on the other side using your left leg. So yoga tones up muscles all over the body, while weight training typically flexes out one muscle group or one muscle at a time. So it's a wise idea to combine both the practices together for the overall strength of bones and muscles.